The ugly, which most of my paintings go through, is part of the process. It's interesting how this occurred. I had chosen a couple of hues that I wanted to use on top of this phthalo blue, and I was thinking lighter, just more color, you know, contrasting with the phthalo blue, you know, just working that balance. And this is the result. And I didn't figure it out until this morning, where I was just sitting and looking at it, which is what I often do at this particular stage, because I really don't know where to go with it. I sat down and I looked at it. I said, you know, this is exactly how I'm feeling. All right, just take a look at this. Okay, it's muted, it's somewhat confused. I had a wonderful foundation of phthalo blue here, high contrast with the white of the canvas. They seemed real direct and positive and confident. And then this happened yesterday. Edges here, just to not necessarily compartmentalize what I did, but maybe offer up some sort of a direction that I may want to follow from this point on. But I just wanted to share with you this is what I'm going through, and this is what I talk about when I talk about my process. I don't honestly know what's going on while I'm doing it, and I don't figure it out until afterwards. This is all my subconscious at work here. The only conscious thing was choosing the colors I was going to use. So this is my process, and I don't figure it out until after I sit and take a look at what I've done, and then it doesn't necessarily make sense, but it becomes more clear. The ugly, I have to get to that point before I can really bring out the beauty and the peace. And there are parts that I really like that I'm hoping will stay. They may not though. I'm gonna try not to focus too much on them and paint around them, so to speak, because that doesn't work either. That definitely does not work. I've said to my students many times and other artists, if there's a part of my painting that's really working but the rest of it is not, I gotta get rid of it. So we'll see what happens from here. Anyways. Started with that, you know, that rush of phthalo blue and that first image set against the white of the canvas. That's where it started from. And it's interesting how I kept that same sort of figurative image up until the end. I mean, it obviously, from what you saw, went through a lot of different changes, from different hues to turning it different directions. And it just, when I look back at the video, I myself am a little bit surprised at how many different things that happened during this particular process. And I think a big part of it is this piece was trying to tell me something all along. And that's why I ended up keeping that same foundation. It wanted me to keep that same figurative image because, you know, my work is autobiographical. It comes from me, it comes from inside, my intuition and my subconscious. And I don't necessarily know what's happening while I'm doing it. So the piece was egging me on, you know, encouraging me to keep this basic structure because this piece had something to say to me. And it definitely did. There's some intriguing parts of this that have shown through, that have survived, I guess, that initial, from the initial piece that I started. One of them is this interesting sort of shadow off of this figurative image right here. It's like a winged figure. I also see down here, landscape, okay? You may not be able to see it, but if you zoom in closer, you might. There's sort of a landscape feel to this. There's sort of a horizontal shape here with almost tree-like structures coming up from there. I mean, the landscape influences me intensely around here. I mean, because of where I live. And that's wonderful to see. I love how it comes out of my work in very interesting ways. And then, of course, I repeated these same colors and shapes up on the top here. Another interesting part is this sort of web of drips that I chose to leave in. They were a lot more prominent early on, but I decided to mute them out just a little bit so they didn't compete with this figure too much. And they appear to me like, when I look at it now, they appear to me like they're stabilizing the figure in some sense, providing an even more foundation. Or maybe it's the figure spreading its roots to other parts, okay? It could be that as well. Also these drips up here, it's almost like they're binding the wing parts together, but not really, they're dissipating. And I think that has something to do with the figure and the amount of freedom that appears to have, that it's breaking loose, for example. I see that in this piece, definitely. There's also an interesting, and you may not be able to see it, there's an interesting face. And a lot of times in my work, sometimes after a year or several years, I notice faces in my work. Can't explain it, it just is. So anyways, you've got this winged part here that's sort of setting the image forward. Not sort of, it is. It's pushing it forward. And these interesting, mysterious-like shapes in the background, they give you something else to look at as your eyes are moving around the piece. So, when I think about this piece overall, when I reflect on it, it is definitely about, obviously, releasing some sort of subconscious, maybe internal trauma that's going on, especially now with the way things are in the world. Things are uncertain. I mean, they're always uncertain, but more so now than at other times in my life. And so the piece was trying to say, okay, just break free of the shadows that have held you back in the past, or maybe different behaviors that you've engaged in that are no longer necessary. Change it up a little bit. That's what I think this piece was trying to tell me. So that's why it kept egging me on to keep working on it. Because sometimes when I get really frustrated with the piece, I will set it aside and I won't get back to it for months. But the piece was saying, no, you got to finish this one. You got to finish it now. So the title is going to be Out of the Shadows. And shadows are not good or bad, okay? It's just... They provide structure
and structure in our lives. You know, shadows are our past, maybe where we've come from. They're important, but we should not be drugged back by them. We should not sit in them, and instead, you know, move beyond them to a different place. Certainly would love any comments that anybody has regarding this piece. And you may have different ideas about what you see. That's the beauty of abstract work. It's not necessarily what, you know, I did it for me, yes, but viewers are gonna see something different depending on where they're coming from. I always appreciate that and accept those particular responses as well. So feel free to respond.